Hi guys, welcome. My name is Roger Ribeiro. I'm currently in Western Cape, South Africa, public strand, and I'm in lockdown like most of you. COVID-19 has got me grounded. This gave me an opportunity to have a look at my video collection, my clips, and I found 2 terabytes of my journey to getting my PPL in South Africa, which led me to think, wow, it wouldn't be nice if way back then in 2017 or 2016, when I was thinking about becoming a pilot, if there wasn't something that I could have searched for and given me some kind of idea, what was the requirements, what were the pitfalls, and what would I expect on the journey from a financial point of view, definitely, as well as to make better decisions in flying schools, etc. And there was nothing out there, nothing that I could find. So I thought, well, maybe kill 2 birds with 1 stone. I'll give you my PPL journey, broken down into several segments. This is part 1, which is just the introduction. And at the same time, share my opinions and my advice regarding those that wish to do a PPL, what the requirements are from a legal point of view, and what decisions you'd have to make in order to make that journey as easy as possible and as cheap as possible. And that is available to you if you apply your mind and make grounded decisions before you take to the air. The legal requirements are pretty simple. You must be 18 years of age when you get your PPL. You're allowed to do your solo once you turn 17. There's no, as far as I know, restriction on age. You can be 100 as far as I know, as long as you pass your medical and you qualify. In the case of a PPL, you require Class 2 medical, which is determined by an aviation medical practitioner. Yes, you need your medical in order to get a student pilot's license, and once you got a student pilot's license, you then are able to pursue your PPL license, which is your private pilot's license. And that's the first step of the journey for you if you intend to become a professional pilot, where you then go on to either get your instructor's license thereafter and use those hours accumulated to get your commercial pilot's license and move on to your ATPL, Airline Transport Pilot's License. The costs involved to get a license, people will tell you, are in the region of 100,000 Rand. It's possible. My personal opinion is that it's understated. You require 45 hours in order to get your private pilot's license, 30 hours dual with an instructor, and 15 hours solo. It's extremely unlikely that you'll get your pilot's license in 45 hours. I know of actually no one who has done it personally. I'm not saying it's impossible, but it's extremely unlikely. Most people must probably do it in 55 to 65 hours. I know of people that have taken 120 hours. This is all dependent on finance and availability of aircraft, weather, and opportunity. So, you know, it may be that you run out of finance and you're only able to fly 2 months later, which requires recaps, etc., because you haven't been in an aircraft. The cost is more than likely around 130,000 Rand, and this is 2020 prices. I would say bargain no less than that. That would include all your hiring of the aircraft and include your instructor's fees. You may have to pay a club fee because a lot of these flying schools belong, are located in a club, and you require club membership in order to fly in using the club's runways. And that will vary from club to club. You also have got examination fees. There are 8 exams which you need to pass. The pass mark is 75%. There's 18 exercises that you will do, the last one being navigation, and then you're going to go for your test and get ultimately your private pilot's license. I will list on the video what those exercises are and what the exams are that you need to pass, so you can use them for easy reference and to guide you what you need to do. The idea behind it is to fly at least twice a week. That would be preferable. Sometimes that's not possible, often because of weather. It will also be ideal to do your theoretical training in line with your flying. What I mean by that is there'd be no point, for example, to fly, and then once you get to way forward to the point where you're almost at your navigation, and you're then going to do your first exam, say aircraft general. That wouldn't make any sense. So the idea would be you're going to climb into an aircraft, so therefore do aircraft general first and technical, and then air law because you're going to fly. So those would be the first two things that you'd be applying. And obviously navigation, you'd use navigation, you'd do the navigation test right at the end when you're about to do your navigation. So that would make sense. In my case, I chose to do 2 to 3 flights a week, and I chose to do 1 exam per week. Sometimes 1 every 2 weeks, depending if it was a particular theory that I found it difficult. If I found it easy, I would do 2 in 1 week. So in the end, the average would be 1 a week. There's 8 exams, 8 weeks, 2 months, get your license in 3, which is basically what I did. The exams, I have a pass mark of 75%. Some exams can be as long as 2 hours. They're all multiple choice. Don't be fooled. There's no such thing as a really wrong answer. It's which answer is more right. And that's not so easy, so you can't really guess. Once you've actually completed your exam, you're actually in a sealed room. In my case, it was a locked environment with a camera. I wasn't allowed to take anything inside. And once you complete the exam online, you immediately get your result and your outcome, and you will know the good news or the not so good news that you've actually failed. And if you failed, you'll have to wait, I think it's 72 hours before you can rewrite it. Having said that, guys, flying is something that you have to take seriously. You have to apply yourself and commit yourself to. It's not a hobby. It is actually a profession, and it involves people's lives, especially your own. And you have to apply yourself diligently to the craft. There's nothing more rewarding to eventually conquer it and to be able to take an aircraft up into the air and go wherever you wish to go and see the beauty of this country or wherever you may go. It's something that only 0.1% of our population is able to do. So we must appreciate that we are rare kind. I've made this video as realistic as I possibly can. What I meant by this is that I've taken the clips, I've not edited any mistakes. Conversations that happen in the aircraft will be on the clips. Some of the clips are a little bit lengthy. Bear with me, watch them, especially if you intend to fly as a student, because there's a purpose to the madness, in the sense that I wanted to show you the progression. And progression is not just about the craft of a person improving a skill, but also from body posture and confidence, and the way you can actually see from the beginning when I am extremely nervous and unsure, to when you can actually relate that looks like this guy knows what he's doing. And I did that on purpose so I can motivate others not to give up when times are tough, and times will get tough. There will be times where you're going to question yourself. I've known people that have cried in planes on their solos. I've known people that couldn't get out of their planes, their legs just wouldn't move. But everybody reacts differently to this, but we are basically all a band of brothers, and we share an absolute love for flying. And I hope that right now I'm talking to the next future aviator. So enjoy my journey to get my PPL, and hopefully it can inspire you to get your private pilot's license. No, just actually the plane's the important thing, not the pilots. We are just baggage. I think this plane, if it was stalled, it could fly by itself a lot better. Hey, wow. There you go, Eric. Have a smile, man. There you go.
star. We just props. Well, you could easily put the computer to it. It would have a brain. Your prop?
Pump off first.
Is it off first, not off that side?
Yeah, pump off first.
Oh, is it?
No, that one.
for the broken hearted. A silent prayer for faith departed. I ain't gonna be just a face in the crowd. You're gonna hear my voice when I shout it out loud. It's my smile.